Join me for a 43-minute trip around the islands of the Bristol Channel. The film starts at Burnham-on-Sea. It then takes you to Breen Down and the Victorian fortress that juts out into the Bristol Channel. Having toured the Victorian fortification, we'll then move on to the mysterious island of Steepholm. Lying offshore from Weston-super-Mare, for many visitors to the town, this is a mysterious little island. The island is owned by the Kenneth Allsop Trust, who run it now as a nature reserve, but it does have quite a history, as this film will show. This is the remains of the old pub, once a duty-free drinking haven. Just like Breen Down, the islands were fortified by the Victorians to ward off the French invasion, which really never happened. But the cannons are still there, lying around on the ground. The island played an important part in the Second World War, as part of the country's air defences. Seabirds and monkjack deer are the only residents on the island now, along with these interesting cave spiders. Wild plants abound, and there is a unique peony which only grows on Steepholm. Victorian barracks now serve as a visitor centre and cafe for light refreshments. After Steepholm, the film will take you over to Flatholm, just off the Welsh coast. The Bristol Channel is well known for its strong currents, and it's the second highest tidal range in the world. The lighthouse is no longer in use, but in front of it is one of the old Victorian bunkers. On this island, the guns were mounted on wooden carriages deep inside these hidden bunkers. Once again, these massive cannons that were never used in anger lie scattered around on the ground. This ingenious tiled slope is how the Victorians gathered their rainwater. These ruins are all that remains of the old cholera hospital. The history of the island is maintained in the small museum. And for those who like a drink, there's also a small pub. The first telegraphic message was sent from Steepholm by this man, Marconi, in 1897. It's an interesting coastline, and there are some wonderful views. But then again, there's always a surprise around the corner. not what I expected to find in the Bristol Channel. A great photo opportunity, though. After Somerset and Wales, the film will then take you on down to Devon and a visit to Lundy. Looked after by the Landmark Trust, Lundy is a truly spectacular island. The coastline is absolutely spectacular, and the water so crystal clear. No longer in use, but once this was the highest lighthouse in Britain. And when you get to the top, what a view you get to see. It is an incredible coastline, and just a bit further along are these really strange rock formations known locally as the Cheeses. Just inland are these rugged ravines known as Earthquake. There are holiday cottages on the island, and of course, a welcoming small pub. There really is something quite unique about Lundy. I was lucky enough to enjoy good weather, but I'm sure if you go, you'll want to go back. Well, I hope you've enjoyed my short trailer. The main film is actually 43 minutes long and contains an awful lot more information than has been shown in this short film. It's been incredibly well received so far and was only released in May 2014. It makes a great gift for people who haven't been, and it's a great souvenir for those who have visited some of the islands or all of the islands of the Bristol Channel. So why not visit www.digipix.net, where you can place an order for your very own copy.